fast asleep. So I told him, okay, you stay over, there's no problem at all. He didn't stay one night, he stayed 2 years. He just refused to go back. But he didn't want to act. He just didn't want to act. He said, I have a girlfriend called Gauri and she is forbidding me from acting in movies because I have to hug girls in movies. So I can't do movies, I can do TV. So I said, okay, it's up to you. And then at one point, his mother died. He came back to Bombay. He decided he would do films. We decided we would start the ball rolling with a film which I wrote called Raju Bhangia Gentleman. You must have heard of it.
Yes, sir.
You must have seen it. I also acted in him. I sold him a car which he didn't buy. But I had one condition. And this is where the story gets interesting for all of you. I said, we will not start making this film until you don't sign 3 other films. This film is not to give you a film to act in. This film is to give you a long time, long career. Fair enough? So until you don't understand the business with all the knowledge that you need, and with that knowledge you don't go out into the world and you don't sign 3 other movies, there's no point in starting this. We'll make this film, it'll fail, the investors will lose money, you'll go back to Delhi and do what? So gradually he sat with me, every day we'd watch movies, every day we would talk to filmmakers, we would understand the business of cinema. And he realized the golden rule. The first rule is, understand your job. Everyone comes to Bombay to become actors thinking that the job is acting. It's not true. In films, acting is not the job. What is the job? Anybody? I told you last time. The job is to sell movie tickets. It doesn't matter if it's a good performance or a bad performance. I wouldn't know the difference. Half the country loved Devdas, half the country loved Devdas and Shah Rukh in it, half the country hated Shah Rukh in Devdas. You tell me whether it was a good performance or a bad performance, I don't know. It was a profitable performance. And once he understood that his primary job was that his producers, who were his employers, have to make a profit when they pay him. Have to make a profit when they pay him a salary to act in their films. It is his job, because it is his face on the poster, to make sure that they get their money back. Fair enough? Because every time he acts in a film and it fails, and his employers lose money, there won't be too many employers left to hire him. And then no matter how good a performance or how bad a performance he gives, there will be no one to give him work. So it is not a question of you thinking you've given a good performance, or you thinking that the director has directed you in a good performance, or that it's a good script. So we come to rule number 2. Good and bad are subjective words. Half empty, someone will be right. Half full, somebody will still be right. 40 cc of water is in this. It's factual. That's when you start understanding that when you strip everything off down to the basic facts, not the truth, you will be able to create a formula or a strategy to become successful. The aim was not to make Shah Rukh into an actor. The aim was to make him into a successful actor with a sustainable career. Correct or not? There have been enough people who've been launched in enough movies who've just disappeared. So I told him, I mean, we can make Raju Bhangia Gentleman, it'll be one film, and if it fails, and it'll only fail because enough tickets don't sell, then you don't have a career, you have a film, which may lead to 2 or 3 more stray films, but it won't give you a sustainable career.